Hello everyone, welcome back to our Design a Camera tutorial. Last time, we demonstrated how to create the camera's back cover. Today we are going to show you how to create the camera lens in ZW3D. Let's begin. First, create variables for the lens which will be used in the following sketch, and then draw a sketch on XY plane for the preliminary lens shape. Draw the draft outline first and then add the dimension and constraints to make the sketch well defined. Use the revolve function from the ribbon menu and select the previous sketch as the target profile, then we will get the preliminary lens shape. Next, create the mount for the lens glass. We can use the reference tools in the sketch module. Then use the extrude command to generate the mount. There are several convenient tools to help you easily define the start and the end point of the extruded feature. Remember to set the end caps type for the profile settings. Now, let's create the lens protection glass in front of the lens. For this case, the femdome function is applied. After creating the protection glass shape, you can add the texture to it. Select a JPG image, put it in the center of the glass, and adjust to the proper size. In the next step, I will create the anti-skid slot. Firstly, draw the sketch. In this case, we can also use the reference tool to create the sketch. After creating the sketch and adding the dimensions and constraints, use the extrude command to cut the target feature. And then use the circular pattern function to finish the remaining anti-skid particles. Next, create another sketch, which will be used to create anti-skid particles. Use the revolve to create the slots first. Then create another sketch and use it to do the Boolean intersection calculation. After that, use the circular pattern to create all the anti-skid particles. For the lens shade, we can also use the sketch and extrude cut to create it. The remaining parts of the lens can be created in the similar way. That's how we design the camera lens with ZW3D. Stay tuned for the next part of our tutorial.